November 16th, 2020 review. Sarah made baskets on some of her shots in a basketball game. If she continues to make baskets at the same rate, how many baskets will Sarah have made after her sixth shot taken? So if we look at this table, it tells us the number of shots taken and the number of baskets made. So it's asking, how many baskets did Sarah make after her sixth shot? So on her for when she took three shots, she made two baskets. So when she took six shots, she made four baskets. Nine shots, six baskets made. 18 shots, 12 baskets made. So we're going to take a look at this, and it says, okay, so after her sixth shot on the hoops, what how many baskets did she make for six, if she took six shots on the hoop? So let's look over here. If she took six shots on the hoop, the basket that she made, the number of baskets made is four. So that's going to be four. So our answer here is four baskets. Four baskets. All right, let's take a look at the next one. The table below represents a proportional relationship between the pounds of cheese to make pizza or the number of pounds of cheese that is used to make pizza. So drag and drop the responses to complete the table. So when we look at this, we're going to complete this table. So we have cheese and number of pizzas. So for cheese, we have 4 pounds of cheese, which makes 8 pizzas. So 4 pounds of cheese makes 8 pizzas. We need to figure out how many pounds, 8 pounds of cheese makes how many pizzas. So we can either look across or we can look up and down. But here's the issue if we do look up and down. So if we look up and down here, if we say, okay, 4 to get to 13, you can't get to 13 from 4 that easily. So we might not want to use that at first. So let's try our arrows. So if I go to this right here, oops, I need to put those in the front. If I go to the right, where did I bring the front? There we go. From the cheese to the number of pizzas, so 4 to 8, how do I get to 8? Well, I know from 4 to get to 8, we are going to multiply by 2. Multiply by 2. If I go from 8 to get to 4, I know we're going to divide by 2. So the opposite or the inverse of multiplying by 2 is dividing by 2. So that's how we're going to take a look at this table. So dividing by 2. All right, so let's take a look. So what the arrow is going to point to our empty box. So this arrow is pointing to our empty box here. This arrow says, okay, so if we go from the cheese to the number of pizzas, we're going to multiply by 2. So 8 times 2 is 16. All right, this one has the empty box for the pizzas, or the cheese. So we start with our pizzas. So 20 divided by 2 is 10. Oop, I guess I could drag them. My bad. Again. All right. And then the empty box on this last row, if I have the number of pizzas blank here, the pounds of cheese, 13 times 2 is going to be 26. That's it for the review. Great job.